The deserts of southeastern Arizona are home to some wonderful natural history. Every night, species of army ants swarm the nests of other ants in search of prey.
What characterizes an army ant? Some important morphological features, but I think from the perspective of seeing them in the wild, they're characterized by their mass recruitment and raiding behavior. You see a continuous weaving stream of ants. That will pretty much always tell you that it's the army ants. There's a good number of species, around 150 species in the New World. Most of that diversity is the genus Nivomomyx, somewhere around 115 species. And when they initiate an attack, usually the response of their prey is very strong. That either there's a very strong defensive response in some taxa, and then in others it's a very strong evacuation response. So they either fight or evacuate and avoid conflict as much as possible.
To simulate an attack by army ants, I'm going to pour 50 to 100 live army ants into the nests of potential prey species. The response of prey to army ants varies depending on the species involved. Harvester ants of the genus Begonomimex show a strong defensive response to attack by army ants. In contrast to that strong aggressive response shown by harvester ants, Nova Mesa show a graded response depending on which species of army ant is attacking them. Nivomomyx swainsoni evokes a weak, aggressive response from Nova Mesa. Nivomomyx texanus evokes a partial evacuation of broods. The most impressive response results from attack by Nivomomyx nigrescens. Nova Mesa workers explode out of the nest, carrying with them pupae and larvae.
The workers that are in the nest tend to take as much of the brood as they can with them, and then give up to the army ants what they leave behind, and then come back to the nest usually after the army ants are done and have moved on. But as far as we know, there are no kind of, you know, whole colony predators of New World army ants that are out there. They're truly sort of the apex top predator in the food webs that they're part of.